But
it's hard to explain what I feel, but it isn't fear. Not a bit. Another one of those gates, like the one I saw in the temple. I'm back to being me. It's hard for me to understand how these gates work. What happens every time I cross one of them? Am I two people and just one person at the same time? I'm not sure if I'm changing or if the laws of physics, and even reality itself, bend slightly to my will. Of this strange technology. What's it for? Something related to the currents? By underground currents. architecture again. Where is this gate going to lead me now?
What a quiet and peculiar place.
Is that black blood the same thing as the black ooze? Although they are the same style, these huts are much simpler than the magnificent architecture I've seen up to now. Whoever the inhabitants were, they were living here against their will. Someone vandalized this mural. Some hands look human, but others are amphibian hands. I wonder who...
We father. We mother.
I understood that. Slaves and masters and... Nicole. The inhabitants of this village lived at different altitudes. Some even lived inside the water. It seems that each family had to agree somehow to change the water level. I'm amazed at how organized they seem to be, despite them being so primitive. Being trapped here probably made them stronger as a community. There are some hand marks made with pigment. I wonder if they mean something. I'd better draw them just in case. quite just lack blood in eyes, like in the well. How can I explain what's happening to me? What is the meaning of all this? God's blood, transformation, eternal life. I feel like I'm going through what was written in that inscription. Water animal. Is that what I am now? made these marks? They look quite old. This civilization used these devices to raise and lower the water level. It's impressive. Creatures of the same species lived here, but they weren't free. They rebelled against their masters. The slaves seemed to worship two gods. Is a beautiful place, but it has also seen a lot of suffering. All the island is that way. Beautiful, but dangerous. The danger does not seem to affect me, though.
Thank you.
illness has kept me from being happy. What I feel now is the complete opposite of being sick. I feel full of life and energy. Even better than before my illness. Now the water level is really low, so I can access that tunnel. These creatures lived like slaves, all their lives imprisoned and tortured in this place. Was it possible to live a decent life in here? If you've lived all your life in a prison, how would you know that you are a prisoner? Now I can enter this tunnel. Ladder. Someone set up camp in here. Looks like a means of transportation to get to that sanctuary.
Seems to show two possible courses of action. One means transformation, and the other means death? This... Oh my God! Did I almost forget about Harry?
My dear old pal. It's only Cass and me now. I have much to thank her for, even if our friendship is worn thin due to hunger and fatigue. If she hadn't insisted so much, we'd never have convinced Teharoa. He guided us as we followed the river down from the mountain peak. And that's how we found this entrance. And the mural. Maybe I can't undo what's happening to you, Norah, but I think I can try to become like you. The original inhabitants of this island took slaves to a sanctuary. And there, they performed a ritual. Teharoa said the ritual was madness, and he didn't want any part of it. He and Cass argued, violently. When we woke up the next morning, he had left. I know it sounds strange, but you have to trust me, my love. I know this is going to work, and we can be together. You understand what that means, don't you, Norah? We have a second chance. With more love than ever, Harry.
Harry? What ritual are you talking about?
You followed the river from the temple summit, and it took you some days to find this entrance.
You don't even know if that ritual of yours is going to work. Harry, that look on your face. You look deranged.
They seem to loathe you.
She doesn't seem to care much about Harry. And she doesn't seem to be thinking straight either.
You followed the river from the temple summit, and it took you some days to find this entrance.
Somebody painted these symbols on the wall. Harry, was that where you went? Oh dear, poor people. Is this...
So the guide left the expedition. That would explain the workshop on the White Sand Beach, where I arrived.
The sun is setting. It is so beautiful. This panel looks different from the others. It's much more elaborate. To the sanctuary. So this boat will take me to the sanctuary. Nothing bad is going to happen to me here, as menacing as this place might look. The island, the ooze, those sea creatures. They're just defending themselves, like a wild animal against an unknown threat. That's how they perceived the expedition, like a threat. But I, on the other hand, I wasn't a threat. And I definitely wasn't unknown, was I? They seem to recognize me, as if I was one of their own. Everything seems so distant now, as if I first stepped on that white beach thousands of years ago. A full moon? It can't be. Yesterday was a new moon. Did I lose track of time, or... Maybe this place isn't subject to the laws of physics. That's the only explanation I can find for this surreal night. It's hard to believe everything is real. Maybe it isn't. Maybe I'll open my eyes sometime and I'll be back in our home in Inglewood and... everything will be as before. My perfectly ordinary life with Harry. My daily routines. My illness. That will be as before, too. And then I'll need to shake off this strange feeling that I have now. Feeling that I don't really belong there anymore. And with there, I don't mean Englewood, or Boston, or Newburyport. I mean... How is it possible that the strange events of only 2 days on this island makes more sense to me than the life that I've been living for years? Sanctuary.